Good morning and happy new year. For those who make new year's resolutions, one of those might be starting a new exercise routine or changing up what you're doing in terms of exercise. Now, some of you might be changing your exercise routine because of different lockdowns that might be going on. Like, for example, we are now into lockdown. I believe gyms are starting to close down. So maybe you're just changing up your routine slightly. So what I will do today is focus on what kind of shoes are best for exercise, because looking for the best shoe will help you prevent pain, especially if you're changing up your exercise routine. When you're changing your exercise routine, a lot of times it can change the stress put onto your body. So even if you're increasing the intensity, the duration, or even just changing your exercises, so going from weightlifting to more cardio or just changing your exercise in general, that can change the stress on your body, which can make you more susceptible to pain. Wearing the right shoe that gives you a good amount of support, cushioning, and if that fits you properly, that can make a big difference in preventing pain. So first, you want to make sure that you're actually using a shoe built for exercise. So a running shoe would be probably your best bet. Could be a walking shoe if you're doing more walking activities. But if you're doing things like high impact activities, your HIIT exercises, any running, a running shoe would probably be your best bet. The difference between a running shoe and a walking shoe is that your running shoe tends to be a little bit lighter, might have a little bit more cushioning on it. So the benefits of having a walking shoe is it has a wider base of support. So that's the bottom of the shoe here. So it tends to be a little bit wider, so it gives you a little bit more stability. Also, a lot of times walking shoes will have something called a rocker sole, which is that curved area at the front, helps propel your foot forward and prevent your muscles from working as hard when you're walking around. Going back to a running shoe, they tend to have a little bit more cushioning through the midsole here, which is this area. So if you push at it, it should be a lot more cushioned. So that will give you some shock absorbing when you're doing those higher impact activities so that your body isn't taking it and the shoe will be absorbing that instead. I talk about this quite a bit, but especially when you're using your shoes for exercise, you want to make sure that it has all the support. So make sure it doesn't bend very easily through the middle. Try and twist it, try and bend it. So it shouldn't bend very easily through here. If it bends a little bit at the toe, that's okay. We're more looking at through right in the middle of the shoe. You also want to look at the heel, make sure that doesn't bend easily. So take your thumb and push at the back of the heel so it shouldn't collapse completely. There should be some solid piece there to keep your heel in place and give you that support. You also want to make sure the shoe fits you properly. Looking at the length, you should have about a thumb between the end of your shoe and the end of your toe. So it's about half an inch approximately. If your heel is sliding out, there could be a problem with the width or the depth. So looking at the width, make sure that you're not bulging out of the sides. That means it's too tight, or that there's not a lot of room on either side. So you should be just around the edges, not bulging out, and there shouldn't be a ton of room. And then the depth is kind of the volume inside the shoe. So a good way to test that is to try and pinch the end of the shoe around the toes, and you shouldn't be able to pinch your fingers together. But you should be able to give you, there should be a little bit of slack there. It shouldn't be extremely tight. So if there is a lot of room in there, a couple ways you can deal with that is look for a different brand. Sometimes different brands have different depth in there, or add an extra insert. So some shoes will come with two inserts. So this one here has the original insert, and then it also has an extra one. So this extra one is nice and flat. It will just fill up the shoe so that you're not sliding around too much. Once you've found a nice supportive shoe and it fits you properly, you might also want to consider looking at additional support in the shoe. Depending on what's going on, you can add an extra over-the-counter insert with just a little bit of arch support, or you might need a custom insert. You can always get your feet checked out, see if that's necessary. but that might help you prevent pain in the future as well. Now, if you're looking for specific brands of shoes, the running shoes that I typically recommend are New Balance. New Balance is nice and wide. So if you have a very wide foot, New Balance is always my go-to. Brooks is also another good one. Saucony and Asics. If you have more of a narrow foot, Asics might be a better option. They tend to have a little bit of a narrower fit, but all of those brands have multiple width options. So you can choose a wider width or a narrower width to fit your foot a little bit better. There are other brands out there that are good running shoes, but general rule is make sure that has all those features I talked about, as well as different width options, and make sure that it's not very thin through that midsole. If it's very, very thin, then you're not getting a lot of cushioning through there. So if you look for all those features, the shoe might be good, even if it's not those brands that I just mentioned. With all of those tips, hopefully that gives you a better idea about what shoe to get when you're starting or changing up your exercise routine. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out and I would be happy to help.